Today we will be going over the basic functionality of the GX3R unit. Let's begin by pushing and holding the power mode button till you hear one beep and then release. When your unit is due for calibration or for bump, this screen appears. It will indicate that your cal or your bump has reached the limit and you have two options to choose from here. You can hit the power mode button to go into user mode and perform your calibration or bump, or you can hit the air button to bypass and just confirm to use, and the unit will begin to go through its warm-up sequence, showing you its date, the battery level, the sensors that are active in the unit, full scales of each sensor, the warning, low alarm, your high alarm, your STEL and TWA, the user ID and station ID, and now the unit is on in normal operation. To perform a fresh air adjust from the normal operation screen, it would just be pushing and holding the air button until it tells you to release. Now we'll be going through the display mode by using the power mode button. It will display your peak readings, which are reset every time the unit is turned off and then back on. STEL and TWA that it has detected since the unit has been turned on. The ability to change the target gas that your LEL sensor is detecting for, as well as your user and station ID assigned to your specific unit. You can display when each sensor was calibrated and the current date, time, and temperature on the GX3R unit. And you can also display the alarm points for each sensor. And then it brings you back into your normal operation screen. When your unit does experience a gas alarm, you will want to evacuate the area immediately. If your unit is set to latching, once the values have gone below or above for oxygen, the warning alarm level, you can hit the power mode button to clear that alarm. If your unit is set for non-latching, the unit will clear the alarm on its own once the values have gone below or above for oxygen, that warning alarm. And then in order to shut off your GX3R unit, the exact same way that you turned it on, you push and hold your power mode button until it says turn off, and the screen is no longer illuminated.